Hello viewers, if you are new to the channel, please hit the like and subscribe button and share it with your friends. Also, click on the bell icon so that you get the latest information about the videos that are uploaded. Hello students, welcome back to the new video. In this video, we are going to continue the ongoing chapter number 11, Transportation in Animals and Plants. In today's session, we will discuss about the structure of heart. Students, now you know that the circulatory system consists of three components, blood, blood vessels and heart. We have already learned about blood and blood vessels. Today, we will discuss about the structure of heart. As you know, heart is an important part of the human body. The heart is one of the most important parts of the human body. It is located between the lungs, slightly tilted towards the left lung. So, heart, which is one of the most important part of our human body, where it is located? It is located between the lungs. You know that we have two lungs. In between the two lungs, the heart is situated. Exactly speaking, it is slightly tilted towards the left lung. So, in the chest cavity, the heart is located between the lungs, slightly towards the left lung. It is well protected by the rib cage. See, the heart, lungs, all these important parts are well protected by the group of ribs or the bones called ribs, and that together it is known as rib cage. So we can say that heart is well protected by the rib cage. It is about the size of our closed fist. So how big is our heart? See, this is our fist. So if we take the closed fist, we can say that our heart is having the size of our closed fist. Further, heart is a muscular structure. That is, it is made up of muscles. But what type of muscles? It is made up of strong cardiac muscles, which protect it from shock and mechanical injuries. So, heart is made up of strong cardiac muscles. And what is the importance of cardiac muscles? It can protect the heart from shock and mechanical injuries. So, heart is completely protected. Now, it is a powerful pump-like structure that pumps blood into the blood vessel. That is its main function. What is heart? What is its function? Heart is a pump-like structure and it pumps blood to the blood vessels. And you know that blood vessels carry blood to all parts of our body. It beats about 60 to 80 times in a minute. So, what is the rate of our heartbeat? That is 60 to 80 times in a minute. Now, let us see the structure of the heart. Now, you know that our heart is having the size of our fist. So, the human heart is divided into four chambers. The upper two chambers, that is right and left, are called the atria. And the lower two chambers, both right and left, are called the ventricles. So, what does it mean? Our heart, which is having the size of our fist, is divided into four chambers. The upper two chambers are called the atria. Atria is the plural form and atrium is the singular form. And the lower two chambers, both right and left, are called the ventricles. So, two upper chambers, atria, and the lower two chambers are called the ventricles. See, the atria are smaller than the ventricles and have thinner walls. So, the upper two chambers, that are atria, is comparatively smaller than the lower two chambers, that is called the ventricles. And atria is having thinner walls. Further, the atria receive blood from the different parts of the body. So they are connected to the veins that carry blood to the heart. Students, we have learned that there are three types of blood vessels. Out of that, veins bring blood from all parts of the body to the heart. So here the atria is receiving blood from different parts of the body to the heart. So they are connected to the veins that bring blood to the heart. So the upper two chambers called atria receive blood from all parts of the body to the heart. Next, the lower two chambers, that are ventricles, they are larger, stronger pumping chambers that send blood out of the heart. So what is the main function of the ventricles? Ventricles send blood out of the heart. So they are connected to the arteries that carry blood away from the heart. So what is the function of the arteries? Arteries take or carry blood from heart to different parts of the body. Since ventricles pump blood to the blood vessels away from the heart, they are connected to the arteries that carry blood away from the heart. Further, the atria and ventricles are separated from each other by walls which have valves in them. These valves allow the movement of blood only in one direction. So the atria and ventricles are separated by valves which have valves in them. And what is the function of these valves? That will allow the blood flow only in one direction. So the valve between right atrium and the right ventricle is called the tricuspid valve, and the valve between the left atrium and left ventricle is called the bicuspid valve. So where do we find tricuspid valve? It is between right atrium and right ventricle. And where do we find bicuspid valve? It is between left atrium and left ventricle. Next, the right atrium opens into the right ventricle and the left atrium opens into the left ventricle. So due to this structure, the blood flowing in the right side of the heart is completely separated from the left side of the heart. That means the right and left side of the heart is completely separated. The blood flowing in the right and left side of the blood is not getting mixed up. See, the deoxygenated or impure blood flows through the right side, while the oxygenated, that is pure blood, flows through the left side of the heart. So where do we find the deoxygenated or impure blood in the heart? In the right side. And the oxygenated or pure blood is found in the left side of the heart. Further, a partition called septum separates the right side of the heart from the left side and prevents mixing of the oxygen-rich blood and carbon dioxide-rich blood. We have seen that the right side of the heart receives deoxygenated or carbon dioxide-rich blood and the left side of the heart receives oxygen-rich or pure blood. So, these two blood should not get mixed up. So, how it is achieved? By the help of a muscular partition called the septum. So, septum separates the right and left side of the heart and prevent the mixing of oxygen and carbon dioxide rich blood in our heart. Now, let us understand the structure of the heart with the help of a diagram. In the diagram, you can see the upper two chambers, that is right atrium and left atrium. And the lower two chambers are called right ventricle and left ventricle. The right side of the heart receives deoxygenated or carbon dioxide rich blood. It is brought by superior vena cava from the upper part of the body and drains it into the right atrium. Here, right atrium receives deoxygenated blood from vena cava and sent it into the right ventricle. The valves, that is the tricuspid valve, allow the blood flow in one direction from the right atrium to the right ventricle. The right ventricle pumps deoxygenated blood to the pulmonary artery.
Here you can see the pulmonary wall. Below that you can see inferior vena cava, which collects blood from the lower part of the body and drains it into the right atrium. Now you can see a muscular structure that is called septum, which separates the right and left part of the heart. This is the left ventricle, which pumps blood to different parts of the body through the aorta. This is the valve that is called a bicuspid valve. It is also called as mitral valve, which restricts the blood flow in one direction from left atrium to the left ventricle. This is the left atrium, and these two are the pulmonary veins, which brings oxygenated blood from the lungs to the heart. And these are the pulmonary arteries, which carry deoxygenated blood to the lungs, where it gets oxygenated. And this is the bigger valve, that is aorta, which carries oxygenated blood to different parts of the body.
So students, I hope you have understood the topics very well. But still, if you have any doubt, you can write in the comment section. I will surely try to solve it as early as possible. Here are some review questions. Please solve it in your notebook. Thank you.